Hey guys, welcome to Motoroids. Today we have come to a very interesting exhibit here at the Auto Expo 2023. With me today I have Vikas Poddar. And he is the founder at Liger Mobility, the company which is claiming to make the world's first self-balancing scooter.
Auto-balancing, we are calling
it. Auto-balancing, of course. And there's an exponent of that scooter standing right there. This scooter can move forward and reverse itself while the rider has his legs up on the footboard. So it's a very unique tech, and I want to start this conversation by asking you, where did this thought come to your mind from as to there was a need for a self-balancing scooter?
Sure. So my co-founder and I, we both come from MP, a part of MP. I'm from Indore, and growing up in a smaller city, you see that, you know, most people of all, despite the age, gender, everyone uses a scooter, right, for all their work, despite having a car. So we felt that if you could do something special, you could do something that is relevant in the scooter space, you'll actually be impacting a lot of, you'll be helping a lot of people, right? And we've seen how the traffic situation nowadays is. So every time you have to stop on a signal or in the traffic, you put your feet down. So we felt that if people don't have to do that, that's, you know, definitely going to add to the comfort of it. And then there's people who find it's so difficult to learn to ride a two-wheeler, right? So we've all seen growing up, like my sister had a fall when she was trying to learn and all of that. So we felt that auto balancing is extremely relevant for most people, and that was basically the inception of the idea.
So it's, of course, it's safer and it's more accessible even to people who don't know how to ride. But of course, you need to have a license before you.
We are going to have a special mode in it, which is called learn to ride mode, in which the speed and the acceleration itself of the scooter is going to be limited to a certain number, and of course auto balancing itself will give more confidence to the new learner.
So this unveils another feature that the scooter has. Similarly, I'm pretty sure that there are other things also about the scooter apart from self-balancing or auto-balancing.
Absolutely.
Which are there to be talked about. So what are the most salient features about the scooter?
So while designing the vehicle, so the first part was obviously auto-balancing technology itself, which is our patented technology, and we've been working on it for the past 5 years, and it has evolved over time. When we were developing the scooter itself, we kept the consumer at the center of the development process and tried to imagine, you know, what are the things that the consumer would want to have. So the battery itself is a liquid cooled battery, and the battery sends 2 lakh data points in a day to the cloud, wherein you are constantly monitoring that, you know, everything's all right with the battery, and if there's any repair or service that needs to be done. So predictive maintenance, for example, the user will get an alert that, you know, now is the time you need to visit a service center, for example. Apart from that, all the scooters are going to be 4G and GPS connected. So the user on an app can see the live location of the vehicle, the past trips and the battery status, you know, things like that. So further, if there's an accident or let's say a tow happening on the vehicle, so the user will get an alert on their phone.
These are all connected scooter tech.
Connected scooter tech, absolutely, yes.
And apart from that, are there any specific modes? Like I just saw that the scooter can reverse itself while auto-balancing.
So we are calling that a reverse ride mode, and basically it's like no more back pedaling. So the first thing is that, you know, with the throttle you are able to reverse, but even then, like if you are in a tight parking spot moving your, so it gets tedious most of the times, right? So with auto balancing, the reverse mode, people have really basically appreciated that.
So when the scooter balances itself, what is the principle that it works on? I'm pretty sure that a lot of people are wondering as to how the scooter can, and also, does it have any impact on the life of the battery? Because there are motors which are keeping the scooter, you know, upright, of course.
Sure.
So does it
That's a good question. On the tech itself, it's an AI-based tech. It's completely been developed in-house. There's a lot of sensor data that we collect from the vehicle, and the AI algorithms basically ensure that the vehicle stays balanced. The principles of physics that we are leveraging to actually generate those torques is what is called as gyroscopic principles of physics. On your second question, we've been working on the engineering part of it, and the power draw is actually very, very minimal. Having said that,
can you
mention? So it will affect around 10% of the battery range.
Okay. Okay.
But overall, I think the way to look at it is that overall this vehicle, basically with the installed capacity and everything, the base variant will give you a 60 kilometer range, and Liger X Plus, which is the higher variant, will give you around 100 kilometers of real world range.
And I think people would also want to know as to what are the price points, because this seems like a fancy ass scooter which has self-balancing.
No, so like I said earlier, that we've tried to keep the consumer and the user and at the center while we were, you know, designing the whole thing. So we've tried to ensure that it's not like a really expensive scooter, and it has been priced accordingly. So the starting price for Liger X will be around 90,000 rupees, including the FAME subsidy. Liger X Plus, we haven't really announced, and exact prices for both the variants obviously will be revealed closer to the sales launch.
Since I have not ridden the scooter myself, I cannot, like, you know, tell my audience as to what it feels like.
Sure.
But now, since there are motors at play,
mm-hmm.
I'm pretty sure that, you know, how intensely the motors come at play also varies with the speed and at the angle of the lean.
So
does it feel different when you're, like, you know, naturally leaning the scooter? Does the motor try to fight you back? How do you, you know, handle a
That's
situation?
Another excellent question, actually. So I'm sure you are a two-wheeler rider yourself,
yeah,
right? So when do you need to put your feet down while you're riding? Only when you are, like, at low speeds,
yes.
Or when you're approaching a stop, right. Or when you are actually stationary, right? You're not moving. So that is when the auto balancing mode will be active, and beyond that, it's on the standby. At which point, it's like a normal, it's like a normal, any other normal scooter, and you ride it like any other normal scooter. At once you're at lower speeds, even then there is a switch basically using which you can activate or deactivate the auto balancing mode. Once the auto balancing mode is deactivated, it's like any other normal scooter which you ride.
So at what speeds? What's the speed range between which?
Up to 5 to 7 kmph is when the auto balancing mode can be activated, beyond
okay.
which it will basically deactivate.
So when you were developing this, right from the beginning, did you, like, start developing the scooter all by yourself, or you had some partners on board? Tell us about the journey.
Sure. So like I said, that we've been working on it for the past 5 years or so, and the initial part was obviously the whole research, because it's never been done before. It's not like something that you pick and plug and play, right? So there's a lot of research that went into it. We at one stage, we got incubated at IIT Bombay. We demonstrated some prototypes to them. So it's been a journey from there. And then once the concept itself was established, then it was about all the engineering that went into actually, you know, making a product that can be taken to the market and which is, like, follows the automotive standards of development. And then integrating the entire, like you're saying, that the whole vehicle development part. So it's been the entire journey of where now that we are closer to production, we actually decide to showcase it to the world, and in the coming months we'll be opening it for sales.
Fantastic, Vikas. It's really amazing to see someone who is starting from the scratch and, you know, creating a vehicle which is so amazing. So, you know, really
thank
inspiring.
You so much. Thank you.
Really,
thank
really
you.
Inspiring. And
appreciate
I'm pretty
it.
Sure that, you know, this will be a great success.
Thank you.
And I wish you all the very best.
Thank you.
And I really hope that the audience, the people, the customers, lap it up, and you know, you establish yourself as a very reputed electric mobility.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
We wish Vikas all the very best, and thank him for taking time out today. As you can see there, there's a lot of crowd there, and he actually wasn't even at the stall, but he made time. So
no worries.
Really, really thankful.
Thank you so much.